Hello everyone, welcome to another video. I just thought I'd do an update video. We're here in Bali getting a lot of editing and work done, and also we've had a lot of opportunities to help animals. I don't know what's been happening, but it's almost like the sick animals know where we are and we keep running into them. But I'd just like to update you on Ubi. Ubi's been going great. We're gonna go check on our little rescue dog Ubi and see how he's traveling.
He's a good boy, I know.
He's looking pretty sad, but he's got his little pillow in there. I love you, pillow. He was still a bit sad when we went to visit him the other day, but we realized we needed to get him a foster family, and Villa Kitty Bali has helped us find a foster family for him. We also seen him just recently, a couple of days ago, and he's looking even better. So thank you to everyone who donated to the Ubi Fund.
Look at you.
All that money will be going to his vet bills, and anything left over will tell you how we'll be spending that money. As I was saying, we've had a lot of opportunities to help many animals here. The first I want to talk about is Lucky. She was literally just about to be slaughtered. We walked out the house, we seen her lying on the grass, we hopped on our scooter and we thought something was up. So after driving for around 10 minutes, we turned back and we convinced the people we're staying with to let her go. Will you let us save this one?
Yeah.
I mean, you don't have to do it for the chicken, but if you do it for us, we'll be a gesture for us. We'll be very grateful.
Please?
Yeah.
For us, thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
This is your lucky day. We also managed to find a new home for her. The reason we're calling is because we stopped him from killing a chicken. Yeah, we saved her. We have a chicken in a kitten basket. We're just wondering, like, what can we do with her?
Hello, we have a hen here.
Yeah.
Some rice for you.
She was literally minutes away from having her throat sliced open and turning into someone's dinner, so very lucky, and she lives up to her name, Lucky. Okay, so we found a new foster mommy. This is Tony. And she'll be looking after Lucky. There are also many kittens who just get left on the side of the road. We found one last night on the way back from dinner. Right, so we're just driving back from dinner and we found another kitten. She looks blind here. She's just in the scooter. So it looks like we're gonna have to take her to get some help. We took her straight to Villa Kitty and they sorted her right out with some medical care.
Little angel.
It was V week for naming kittens, so we named her Vani after my mum Vania. She's absolutely adorable. Now, one of the most horrific cases I've ever seen, and it's probably all too common here in these sort of third world type countries where they can't afford proper vet care and there's so many stray dogs, was this dog we found. So we just found this little dog here on the side of the road here, and I've never seen a dog look so bad. A really bad skin condition and starving to death. Now, she looked absolutely terrible. We didn't know if she was going to make it. She was on the brink of death. We called Villa Kitty once again and they helped us out. They brought someone down to pick her up.
We're gonna get you some help.
Okay, we'll follow you down, yeah?
Yep.
Now, we've got her in the vets as we speak, and we're hoping we can turn her around. We're gonna give her as much care as we can. Her name is Angel. Okay, so we're just waiting on some test results and to see how she's going, but we're gonna hear back very soon. We just always seem to be in the right place at the right time. Hey.
Camilla, she's so cold that the circulation has almost stopped.
I think we need to end this.
Yeah.
Yep.
Glad she didn't suffer out there in the heat.
Mm.
Be a real angel now.
Good girl. Good girl. Be a good girl.
Now, Bali's such an amazing place, beautiful scenery, the cost of living's very cheap, so much wildlife, nature, and animals. We've made a lot of new animal friends.
Okay, so there's a monkey over here, and he looks like he's like a lone ranger. He's by himself, so maybe he was kicked out of his little monkey tribe, but we got him a present. It's mine! That's mine. You're trying to steal it.
What's your name?
This is Mrs. Lion. She lives here, but she's in a cage most of the time, so we try to get her outside the cage as much as we can.
Yeah, you're safe here, right? Nobody's gonna harm you ever. I'll take care of you.
Oh, this is too much for me.
There we go, a nice new home for Lucky. The perfect vegan foster mum. Boom.
Not all the animals here are as lucky as some of the stories I've shown you today. A lot of stray dogs just don't make it. A lot of animals go without care. And also here in Bali, and just like they are in Australia, UK, America, and worldwide, are used and killed for their bodies.
Yeah, in Australia it's the same. They don't kill them on the street, but they eat animals in celebration. So Christmas, Easter, it's the same thing. But except in Australia, they hide the slaughter part.
Yeah.
It's ceremony, yeah. Nah, we also seen they're killing pigs on the side of the street.
So unfortunately, we can't save them all, but all we can do is be the best advocates we can and make sure that when we're traveling, we always fund the vegan businesses and eat the cruelty-free foods, amazing foods, very cheap when you're in Asia. Support those restaurants, support cruelty-free, and always educate those you're around. Teach them that, hey, these animals, they have moral value.
It's just that we value our life, right?
And we can offer them a better life. So thank you so much. Keep following the Dominion Tour journey. There's a few more videos to come. We'll hopefully introduce you to the foster parents of Ubi, and we'll keep pumping out the content. And thank you so much, guys, for all of your support. Peace.
Change. It's time for us as a people to start making some changes. Let's change the way we eat. Let's change the way we live, and let's change the way we treat each other. You see, the old way wasn't working, so it's on us to do what we gotta do to survive. And still I see no changes.